Do not antagonize Chauncey the Tiny Bear. He may be small, but he nips.
Law has asserted itself.
We'll see. Not much better than the road, ask me.
Thank you. work?
Let's see what we have. My scouts report no signs of danger in the pass nearby.
I will arrange patrols to ensure it stays that way.
Good to see you safe, Inquisitor. We've got trouble ahead.
If you're on edge, I should alert the entire Inquisition.
Or increase my hazard pay. That's an option.
Are things that bad?
Crestwood was the site of a flood 10 years ago during the Blight. It's not the only rift in the area, but after it appeared, corpses started walking out of the lake. You'll have to fight through them to get to the cave where Sir Hawk's Grey Warden friend is hiding.
Have any undead attacked the camp?
We've had a few shamblers, but most head toward the village below. Maybe someone in Crestwood can tell you how to get to the rift in the lake. Maker knows they'll want help. Good luck. And please be safe.
Way to get to the rift in the lake.
Swimming?
It sounds different. The water changes the song.
Wardens, thank you for your aid, Inquisitor.
What are you doing in Crestwood?
Hunting one of our own.
We have orders to capture Sir Alistair of Ferelden on site. The man's slippery as an eel. We've been chasing him for weeks.
What have you been told about this rogue warden?
Warden Commander Clarell ordered his capture. I can say no more than that. I hope Alistair comes quietly. I'd not fight the man who helped kill that many darkspawn.
Will you stay to fight the undead here?
My orders forbid it. Crestwood was only a detour. If the Inquisition can help, I beg you to do what you can. The villagers have already lost too many.
Farewell.
Farewell.
Sir, are you sure we can't help the village?
Part of Corypheus' plot to seize the Order.
They stay by oaths sworn in blood. Not theirs, then their own. They're true.
I hope Hawk's warden friend has answers for us.
Did you see how the Grey Warden saved me from those corpses? They're amazing. I'm going to see if they're looking for recruits.
You want to join the Grey Wardens now?
Oh, Baker. You're the Inquisitor.
But yes. The Wardens are heroes. They saved me from those demons, Your Worship. With all that's happening, I'd like to help people the same way.
Find another way to help people. The Wardens have problems of their own right now.
Yes, Your Worship. I'm sure there's something else I can do to help.
Dead by the gates.
Let's do it.
Thanks for your help, but I fear we haven't seen the end of these creatures.
How many did we lose?
Inquisitor? Oh, Mayor Dedrick of Crestwood Village, at your service, despite everything. Are you here to stop the undead?
We should. We could. Everyone here is so scared.
The undead are appearing because of a rift in the Fade. How can I get to it?
The light in the lake? It's coming from the caves below old Crestwood. Darkspawn flooded it 10 years ago during the Blight. Wiped out the village, killing the refugees we took in.
I saw a dam. If we use it to drain the lake, I can get to that Fade Rift.
Drain the... There must be some other way.
There's not. There's really not.
You'd have to evict the bandits in the old fort to use the dam. I can't ask you to risk your life.
Crestwood can't last much longer. I don't want to leave without doing what I can.
I suppose it must come to this. This key unlocks the gate to the dam controls past the fort. The rift must be in the caves under old Crestwood. But, Inquisitor, I would not linger there.
Tell me about your village.
It's seen happier days. We farm what we can, trade with the merchants who travel the King's Road. We only want peace, Your Worship. It's all we've ever wanted.
What can you tell me about the bandits camped in the fort?
The highwaymen? Thugs and thieves. They make a living raiding caravans on the King's Road. When the dead rose from the lake. The bandits killed the old gamekeeper and the fort and took it for themselves. We could have saved people if we'd been able to hide there instead of in our homes.
I'm surprised a town as small as Crestwood outlasted the Blight.
It was a close thing. The Darkspawn followed a band of refugees running from the Blight. Some of the refugees were... they were very ill. But we took them in. They perished when the Darkspawn flooded old Crestwood.
How did Darkspawn manage that?
They found the dam's controls. Wrecked them. All I remember is the refugees and villagers screaming as they drowned. And now... they return to us.
Until later.
Of course.
Inquisitor. I am Sister Vaughan. Does the mayor finally plan to drain the lake? I must find someone to retrieve the remains of those lost there.
Have I interrupted a funeral service?
We lost many friends in the first attack. But there will be endless time to mourn. The fear is how many more will be added to the pyre.
You want to exhume the corpses at the bottom of the lake?
They were the Maker's children. Their earthly bodies deserve better than abandonment in a mire. A funeral service will help put living minds at ease.
What did you mean by finally drain the lake?
The undead returned only after the light in the lake appeared. If we want to stop them, we must investigate. But the mayor sent no one at all. I fear he thinks that emptying the waters would unleash even more monsters on us.
Until later.
Farewell.
Maker, if something happens...
Are you looking for someone named Judith?
Oh, was I speaking out loud? Judith lives outside the village. I asked her to hide here when the undead came, but she wouldn't hear it.
Why wouldn't she hide where it's safer?
Likes her space, she says. I told Judith my house was big enough. Me and the boy could sleep in the barn if she wanted room. She turned me down.
Good day to you.
And to you.
Maker, it's the end of the world!
Be nice for the Inquisition to do some good here.
There's the keep the mayor talked about. And the bandits.
Gate open, no patrols. Risky, but we could rush it.
Sound. The Inquisition might make use of it.
Won't hurt the villagers anymore.
We should drain the lake. The mayor said the dam controls were through the fort.
Welcome, Inquisitor. My name is Charter. Leliana's eyes and ears, especially in this place. I'll have some information for you once my man Butcher finds us. He's running late.
When's the spy named Butcher supposed to arrive?
Half hour ago, by the south gate. I hope he's only delayed. Butcher's last message swore he had secrets for us worth 10 times his weight in gold.
Did Sister Nightingale tell you why she wanted agents here?
We lie on the main road between Denerim and Valroyo. Couriers stop here all the time. For what they're paid, some have surprisingly loose tongues.
I should be going.
Farewell.
So many legs!
He blinks when he has a sweet.
Shh! Inquisitor!
Ah, piss.
We're, just catching up with each other after an assignment.
That part's fine. Just don't lock me out of my own key.
No, Inquisitor. It won't happen again. I swear it.
Nose a little brown, Reeve.
Quiet, you.
Here. The mayor said the dam controls were through this gate. That building on the dam must be where we can open the floodgates.
Wonderful.
The Inquisitor? We didn't know you were here, sir. Please don't tell anyone.
How did you get past the guards?
There weren't any when we got here.
We just heard you killed the bandits, your worship. We didn't know you were moving in, we promise. You won't tell people we were here, will you?
I see you couldn't resist the thrill of a decrepit pub.
There's nowhere else, sir. Everyone is crammed into the village.
Lonnie's parents would have a fit if they saw us. We'll have to wait an hour to go back. Your father will still be up.
I knew this was a mistake.
We could try the caves.
You hate spiders.
You find somewhere next time.
Said Darkspawn destroyed these controls 10 years ago. Who repaired them?
The mayor. His shame had this shape.
Someone nearby. Ward off demons.
Did you
Should we look around? They were scared when the water came.
We're near another artifact. Functioning again.
These spirits must have come through the rift.
They drift, wandering. It's fortunate the rift did not warp them into demons.
One's looking. I'm Cole. Don't be afraid.
Or a demon.
Demon? Those dolts who would suck this world dry. I am called to higher things.
What is a spirit like you called to do?
I lead armies, kingdoms, lords. I am imperial. I am command.
Possibly.
What of you? I felt your coming. Is there something alike in us?
I've only just met you.
Strange world this is, where time blinds you.
Maybe you can give it some guidance, Cole.
Maybe. My name is...
Compassion. Did I ask your name?
Oh, sorry.
Spirits are your expertise, Solas.
Then tell me why nothing here changes.
This realm follows different rules from the Fades. Will alone cannot overcome what you see.
Then what's the point of it?
A solid form is both shackle and strength. It affects more than you imagine.
What's so distressing about the real world?
It ignores me. I order the rocks to part, but they do not. bid the sky draw close and it stays still. I don't know how you mortals stand it.
Why haven't you gone back to the Fade?
I will not be denied. I refuse to leave until something obeys my orders.
Then I feel compelled to help you. I pledge myself to your service.
Excellent. I have only one command. A creature made of rage had the gall to chase me across the lake. Destroy it in my name and be rewarded.
Then how? Why are you picking one of our heads?
Yours holds no interest.
Mayor's old home.
The mayor dreams about this place. Shock and shame and hurt. I don't know why.
We could ask him. A letter from Crestwood's mayor. Damp but legible.
May I help you?
Your house in Old Crestwood is still standing.
It is?
There's not much inside.
There wouldn't be. I was cleaning the place when the waters... when the flood... I didn't ever want to think of that place again. I have nothing more to say. Please.
Okay, am I right? I've already found the remains of the people who died in Crestwood.
That's it, I'm trusting. I didn't imagine you'd look yourself. Thank you for your thoughtfulness. It is all too rare these days. I will prepare the bodies for cremation.
Templars ahead.
They look serious.
Thank you.
enough people, it becomes more wandering, wishing, touched by them. Maker loves you, and it grows. But I am me. Will I be more one day if I help enough? Is this a task timed, temporary?
No. It is a mistake to ascribe human motivations to them.
So I am always this?
You are always you.
Right. You two just work whatever that is out of your system. Like poison. Weird-ass poison.
It's good. I can explain.
I really didn't ask.
Are we going to camp?
Templars. They will show no mercy. We must do the same. Orc's Grey Warden ally should be inside that cave.
Glad you made it. I just got here myself. My contact with the Warden should be at the back of the cave.
He's not the only Warden around here. It's a good thing his friends didn't find him in Crestwood.
Yes, I saw them earlier. They've been told he's a traitor in order to capture or kill him. How much blood is shed by good men following bad orders?
Thank you.
just us. I brought the Inquisitor.
I'm Alistair. It's an honor to meet you, Inquisitor, though I wish it were someplace a bit nicer.
Are you the Alistair who fought the Archdemon with the Hero of Ferelden?
I need to change my name. Yes, that was me. War, betrayal, darkspawn, all lots of fun. And made for excellent stories, I'm sure. Nobody cares about that anymore. I answer to Warden Commander Clarell now. Like everyone else.
Most of you wardens disappear. Then I run into a darkspawn magister named Corypheus. Do you think that one might have something to do with the other?
When Hawk killed Corypheus, the wardens thought the matter resolved. But archdemons don't die from simple injury. I feared Corypheus might have the same power, so I started to investigate. I found hints, but no proof. And then, not long after, every warden in Orlais began to hear the calling.
You never told me.
It was a secret. A very dangerous one. I try to actually keep a few of my oaths to the wardens.
Is the calling some sort of Grey Warden ritual?
Well, wardens are tied to the Darkspawn. We're connected somehow. And eventually that connection poisons you. You get bad dreams, and then you start to hear the music. It calls to you, quiet at first. And then, so loud, you can't bear it. At that point, you say farewell and go into the deep roads to die fighting. In death, sacrifice.
And every Grey Warden in Orlais is hearing that right now. They think they're dying.
Yes, I think Corypheus caused this somehow. If all the wardens die, who will stop the next blight? That's what has them so terrified.
Thanks to the calling, Corypheus has them scared. They're playing right into his hands.
Is the calling they're hearing real, or is Corypheus mimicking it somehow?
I have no idea. Before all this, I'd barely heard of Corypheus. I didn't even know he was supposed to be a magister until I started digging around. But right now, all that matters is the wardens are acting like they're going to die.
You said all the wardens are hearing the calling. Does that include you?
Unfortunately, yes. When I'm talking or fighting, I can almost ignore it. But whenever things are quiet, I can hear it. It's like a song you can't get out of your head. Damned annoying, frankly.
How can Corypheus make all these wardens hear the calling?
I have no idea. I suppose it's part of what he is. Corypheus is tied to the Blight, and not just a product of it, like most Darkspawn. Wardens are connected to the Darkspawn, too. That's how he seems able to control wardens who get too close to him. And that's likely what he's doing here as well. Somehow.
So the wardens are making some last desperate attack on the Darkspawn.
I saw what a blight did to Ferelden. If wardens hadn't stopped it, there'd be no more Thedas. Warden Commander Clarell proposed some drastic things, blood magic and such, to prevent further blights before we die. I protested, maybe too loudly, and Clarell sent guards and, well, here I am. Wardens were gathering here, in the Western Approach. It's an old Tevinter ritual tower. I'm going to investigate. I could use some help.
Let's go.
I heard what he said. Hopefully we'll find some answers in the Western Approach. Though I fear what those answers will be. I've seen too much blood magic to ever trust where it leads.
Thank you.
corpses in the Wyvern, nothing here is safe. What I wouldn't give to get my hands on that animal.
If you're Judith, there's a man in the village concerned about you.
That must be Gould, fretful as ever. I'm glad he stayed in Crestwood. He's fast as you please with a loom, but terrible with a sword.
Do you farm out here?
The name's Judith. I farm and amend things for the village and people passing through. I did a fair trade with traveling merchants before the undead started attacking. Not to mention that dragon.
But you still like living here, rooting where you dig. Your land and no one else's this time.
Well, that's... Aren't you a sharp-eyed one?
There's a Wyvern causing trouble.
It used to hunt in the mountains. Didn't bother anyone but the bandits. Lately, the beast got it in his head to come down here. It almost crippled Gaul's little boy. Best someone kill it. I hope I get my hands on the liver. It makes a poison that kills rats like nothing.
I killed the Wyvern up in the cave. The body's yours if you want it.
That I do. Here, for your troubles. I hope you can make good use of it. A fine day to you.
What do you know about the dragon?
She moved in a month ago. The guards tried to run her off, but she snapped one's head off and she flew away. Poor Hamald. At least it was quick. Since the horses, 5 goats and 2 cats.
Until later.
Be safe.
Thank you.
Well met, Your Worship.
I found Butcher's corpse by the South Road. Red Templars ambushed me afterward.
Only our highest operatives knew he was coming tonight. I must inform Sister Nightingale we have a traitor.
What's happening in Crestwood?
The roads are nearly deserted. Too many undead keep rising from the lake.
I should be going.
Farewell.
Someone needs to deal with the last of Crestwood's highwaymen.
Who has time?
If we clear the bandits out, more travelers. More travelers. More news for the night.
Good point, but I've got a code to unscramble if you want to know who killed Comte Feyeur last week. Are the highwaymen still in Crestwood?
Yes, Your Worship. Now that their fort is gone, the bandits are ambushing travelers.
Crestwood won't stop them either. The town's still reeling from the undead.
Without a partner.
Thank you.
Glad you could make it. We've seen lights coming from the tower.
It has to be blood magic. Steel yourselves. Whatever lies inside won't be pretty. You take point. I'll guard your backs.
Wait!
No!
Warden Commander Clarell's orders were clear.
This is wrong!
Remember your oath? In war, victory, in peace, vigilance, in death?
I'm sorry.
Sacrifice! Oh. Find it just as I showed you. Inquisitor, what an unexpected pleasure. Lord Livius Edamond de Virantium, at your service.
I'm guessing you're not a warden.
But you are. The one Clarell let slip. And you found the Inquisitor and came to stop me. Shall we see how that goes?
Wardens, this man is lying to you. He serves an ancient Tevinter Magister who wants to unleash a blight.
That's a very serious accusation. Let's see what the Wardens think. Wardens, hands up! Hands down.
Corypheus has enslaved them.
They did this to themselves. You see, the calling had the Wardens terrified. They looked everywhere for help.
Including Tevinter.
Yes, and since it was my master who put the calling into their little heads, we in the Venatori were prepared. I went to Clarell full of sympathy, and together we came up with a plan. Raise a demon army, march into the deep roads, and kill the old gods before they wake.
Ah, I was wondering when the demon army would show up.
You knew about it, did you? Well then, here you are. Sadly for the Wardens, the binding ritual I taught their mages has a side effect. They are now my master's slaves. This was a test. Once the rest of the Wardens complete the ritual, the army will conquer Thedas.
Why would the Wardens try to kill the old gods?
A blight happens when Darkspawn find an old god and corrupt it into an archdemon. If someone fought through the deep roads and killed the old gods before they could be corrupted, woof! No more blights, ever. The Wardens sacrificed their lives and saved the world.
That's madness. For all we know, killing the old gods could make things even worse.
Well then, it's a good thing I'm taking this demon army off their hands.
Why would Clarell risk using demons?
Demons need no food, no rest, no healing. Once bound, they will never retreat, never question orders. They are the perfect army to fight through the deep roads. Or across Olay. Now they are bound to my master.
So Corypheus influenced the Wardens and made them do this ritual?
Made them? No! Everything you see here, the blood sacrifices to bind the demons, the Wardens did it of their own free will. Fear is a very good motivator, and they were very afraid. You should have seen Clarell agonize over the decision. Burdens of command, I suppose.
Do you really want to see the world fall to the Blight? What do you get out of this?
The Elder One commands the Blight. He is not commanded by it, like the mindless Darkspawn. The Blight is not unstoppable or uncontrollable. It is simply a tool.
Somebody's certainly a tool.
As for me, while the Elder One rules from the Golden City, we, the Venatori, will be his god-kings here in the world.
Release the Wardens from the Binding and surrender. I won't ask twice.
No, you won't. The Elder One showed me how to deal with you in the event you were foolish enough to interfere again. That mark you bear, the anchor that lets you pass safely through the veil, you stole that from my master. He's been forced to seek other ways to access the Fade. When I bring him your hand, his gratitude will be...
You were right. Thanks to the ritual, the Warden Mages are enslaved to Corypheus.
And the Warden Warriors? Sacrificed? I knew the Wardens would go too far.
Human sacrifice, demon summoning. Who looks at this and thinks it's a good idea?
The fearful and the foolish.
Hawk, they made a mistake, but they thought it was necessary.
All blood mages do. Everyone has a story they tell themselves to justify bad decisions. And it never matters. In the end, you are always alone with your actions.
I may know where the Wardens are. Eremond fled that way. There's an abandoned Warden fortress in that direction. Adamant.
I guess they didn't want to summon a demon army out in public.
The Warden and I will scout out Adamant and confirm that the other Wardens are there. We'll meet you back at Skyhold.
you seen otherwise?
Good to have commerce restored.
I can keep staring at this, but I won't get any closer.
Something I can help you with?
Yes. Possibly. We saw so many Red Templars at the assault on Haven. Perhaps all that was left of the Order. What we didn't see was Lord Seeker Lucius. Indeed, I've seen no hint of any Seekers amongst the Red Templars, or anywhere. I have a growing suspicion Corypheus has imprisoned them.
Why imprisoned? He could just as easily have killed them.
Not easily. But yes, they may be dead. But the Seekers began this war against the mages. They cannot have simply vanished. There must be a trail we can follow, yet so far I have only discovered hints.
But they could have ended up just like the Red Templars.
Seekers do not use lyrium. I assume Corypheus gained control of the Templars by corrupting the lyrium they were already taking. To do the same to a Seeker, you'd have to force the lyrium upon him. That may be what happened, but it couldn't have begun that way. We're missing a piece of the puzzle, Inquisitor. I need to find it.
Finding them obviously means a lot to you.
I left the Order, but I can never abandon them. I cannot even claim that rescuing them would be beneficial. They wouldn't look kindly on the Inquisition. But even so, if there's a chance... If we can spare resources to follow up on these leads, Inquisitor, I would appreciate it.
Thanks for coming.
You did well, Varric. The Inquisitor is just who we need.
Ah, it's been great. Murderous wardens, archdemon attacks, plenty of blood mages and crazy Templars. Just like home.
I know how much you hated leaving Co.
This is the ass end of Thetis. You know they eat snails here? Still, I think I need to finish this out. If it weren't for me and Bartrand, none of this would have happened. So much for changing our lives.
That's what happens when you try to change things. Things change. You can't always control how.
Sister Liliana says the guests are on their way. The last inheritances are discovered, and taupe is not a spring color.
Good. Tell her we've prepared their best stateroom. The inheritors will be contacted, and yes, it absolutely is.
Inquisitor, I must speak with you.
What is it?
I must explain something first about the Montpellier's fortunes.
I remember you said your family had been forbidden from trading in Orlais.
It's devastated our finances. The Montpellier's have, in fact, been in debt for over 100 years.
Debt or no, you appear to be surviving.
That isn't enough. A disaster could wipe us out completely. For generations, we've done everything to keep creditors at bay. Sold our lands to stave off interest. It's just... It is infuriating to see my family still reduced to this. I'm to become head of our house. If I sell any more of our land, my family will become destitute. That cannot be my legacy to them.
Most people worry about their next meal. Never mind an estate.
I'm not blind, but I worry for my family. My foolish sister Yvette with her daydreams, my brothers trying to rebuild our fleet with their own hands. Is it wrong to hope they never know hardship?
Is there anything I can do?
I'd almost solved our problems. For a while. I negotiated a chance to reinstate the Montpelliers as landed traders in Orlais. We could rebuild with that. But when I dispatched paperwork to Val Royaux, I've just learned my carriers were murdered, and the documents restoring my family's trading status destroyed.
Who hates the Montpelliers enough to do that?
Leliana made inquiries that bore success. Comte Boisvert, a nobleman in Val Royaux, claims to know who killed my messengers. He has a request, that you come when I meet him, so he's seen publicly conferring with you.
What will being seen with me gain the Comte?
The Comte will drop hints at parties he's to meet with an important visitor. Allies and rivals will take note. Once he's met you, there will be speculation. The Comte will subtly spin reports to his advantage. He will use us. But if he knows who killed my people, I ask that we indulge him.
I hope the Comte isn't making up information just to be seen with me.
I will take full responsibility if that's the case, Inquisitor. I must know who killed my couriers just to harm my family.
Do you need something, my dear?
Fancy meeting you here.
I'd like to ask you about Tevinter.
Popular topic. Anything specific?
Corypheus is a figure out of Tevinter history. He was a magister.
Yes, but that was a different time. The Imperium's power was at its peak then. The Civil War had ended. The Magisterium was united, its armies scooping up bits of Thedas like candy. The Magisters who entered the Black City. It was a demonstration of how exceptional Tevinter had become.
But who were they?
No one knows. There's no record of a Magister named Corypheus. All this happened 1400 years ago, before the Blight nearly wiped us out. There are no records. Today, people half believe it's all just a story. That's what I believed.
We have evidence the story is very much real.
But not who Corypheus is. If he even remembers. There used to be families who claimed some of those Magisters as their own. That stopped when the Chantry appeared. Then it was shameful, and the families distanced themselves from the tale. All we know is that some men and women entered the Black City looking for the old gods. What did they find? According to Corypheus, nothing. And only he could tell us more.
That's all I wanted to know.
Fair enough.
I should go.
Try not to die. I would notice you were gone.
Silvaric knew where the champion was all along. That's the last time we sent Cassandra to interrogate.
Anything I should know?
It seems that the Olesian army is awaiting our next move. Some of the generals are sympathetic to our cause, others are still suspicious. Our actions are under a great deal of scrutiny.
Anything I should know?
Our agent stationed near Adamant reports strange sounds. Curious lights around the fortress. At least two scouts have gone missing. We must make our move, and quickly.
Anything I should know?
I've nothing to report at the moment.
I'll leave you to your work.
First the Templars, now the Grey Wardens. Both devoted their lives to fighting evil. Now they serve it.
What better way to demoralize the people of Thedas than to corrupt their heroes? If Corypheus appears with Templars and Wardens at his side, why shouldn't they follow too?
Because now is not the time to lose hope. The Inquisition must serve as an example. We must stand where others fall.
You and the Red Templars' leader seem to have personal history.
When I arrived in Kirkwall, Samson and I shared quarters. He seemed a decent man at first. Knight Commander Meredith later expelled Samson for erratic behavior. He ended up begging on Kirkwall streets. He committed further crimes, but managed to evade the Order's justice. Now Samson serves Corypheus as his loyal general.
Why do you think Samson joined Corypheus?
He had a chronic lyrium addiction. He spent every last coin buying it from local smugglers. Perhaps Corypheus flattered his vanity. Gave him purpose, as well as lyrium. Perhaps that's all it took.
You can't deny being a general is an improvement to living on the streets.
I'd rather die than kneel to Corypheus. Clearly Samson felt otherwise. I don't understand how he became so powerful. Even with red lyrium, Samson's glory days are long behind him. Was there something you needed?
Is there anything I should know?
Repairs to Skyhold's fortifications are progressing. Our scouts report no immediate threats in the surrounding area. We are fortunate Solas knew of this place.
Is there anything I should know?
I'd gotten used to mages disliking me on principle. Vivienne's views on Templars are surprisingly traditional.
Is there anything I should know?
Sarah brought me a piece of cake. She thought I looked hungry.
Why are you telling me this?
Because it was either an act of kindness or a trap. I was hoping you knew which.
That's all for now.
I'm sure you have other matters to attend.
Welcome back.
So they don't.
Just what I heard.
This is the start of something grand. I know it.
What do you mean?
Of course.
What can I do for you?
I'd like to talk about you and me.
Sure, boss. What's up?
Those times you talked about passing time with the serving girls. Is this what you do to them?
The serving girls spend most of their day following orders and feeling unimportant. They need someone who makes them feel special. Lets them cut loose with no repercussions. I let them bounce on top and tell them their tits look nice. Everybody wins. I mean, I used to. Long as we're doing this, you've got my complete attention.
You told me that this is what I needed. What did you mean by that?
You're the Inquisitor. You didn't ask for the job, but you've taken on the responsibility. You've got thousands of lives riding on your decisions. You bear that weight all day. You need a place where you can be safe, knowing someone else is in charge for a bit.
I think that's exactly what I need.
Good. Figured you'd have kicked me out if you disagreed.
What about what you need?
I'm good. I'm better than good. You don't need to trouble yourself on that front. Old Iron Bull is just fine.
See you later, Bull.
Nice talking with you, boss.
Inquisitor?
Can you think of any other tasks suitable for the charges?
Nothing jumps out at me. If I come up with any ideas, I'll let you know.
We'll talk later.
Hey.
What's been going on?
Madame de Fer said hello to me. Or maybe she was waving at someone else and I just thought she was. Yeah, that's probably what happened.
Take care.
Much less enthralling.
Careful. Ears.
Of course.
Fertile ground even here. This hold has everything.
Thank you.
need?
I've got a minute if you need something.
How about that?
What can you tell me about this Corypheus?
I'm not exactly an expert, but ask away and I'll answer what I can.
How did you first encounter him?
A few years back, I was dealing with some trouble from a Carter clan that went rogue. They were sending assassins after the Hawk family. We tracked them to a rune in the Vimarks. It turned out to be a trap. Once you went far enough into the rune, there was a magic barrier that kept you from going back. The whole thing was a prison the Grey Wardens were using to hold what they thought was a powerful darkspawn.
I've never heard of Wardens locking up darkspawn. Why wouldn't they just kill him and be done with it?
I don't think they could. From what we saw in there, Corypheus can control Wardens somehow. They couldn't attack him. The Wardens locked him up because there was nothing else they could do.
He looks like some sort of blighted creature, but he speaks. What is he exactly?
The Wardens who imprisoned him thought he was just a darkspawn. But you heard him ranting. He claims he's a magister. One who assaulted the Golden City, what, more than 1,000 years ago? It seems crazy, but if he's telling the truth, he's one of the people who caused the blights.
You and Hawk both said before he was supposed to be dead.
He was dead. We killed him. The only way for us to escape the prison Corypheus was trapped in was to go through him. We weren't going to just leave the door to his prison open behind us and hope he was dead. We made sure.
All right. I think that's enough about Corypheus.
No problem. Looking for someone to talk your ear off? I think I can oblige.
What are your thoughts on the Inquisition?
If there's anybody out there who hasn't joined the Inquisition, they're hiding under a rock. Did you want to take over Ferelden? I think we might be able to conquer it just by looking east.
What do you think of Leliana's work?
She scares me. Mostly in a good way. At least I'm reasonably sure she's on our side.
What do you think of our general?
Find him a war or something. If he spends any more time in the yard drilling, Josephine will have him killed.
How do you think Josephine is handling the job of ambassador?
I'm starting to get the feeling that this is all a warm-up before she takes over Antiva in a bloodless coup.
Good to know.
Back to work, then.
We must stop the Wardens from carrying out this insane plan, Inquisitor! To seek out these old gods deliberately in some bizarre attempt to preempt the Blight.
And calling the army of demons. That's my favorite part.
The demons are nothing. They're a tool.
A tool that gives Corypheus an army.
That's not the point. Even if they could succeed, the entire idea... The Blight is not something one smugly outsmarts. Forgive me. The entire idea is... unnerving. How can I help?
I'd like to hear more about what you saw in your exploration of the Fade.
I would be happy to share it with you.
Tell me about the old ruins you explored.
I found an ancient dwarven taig no longer sheltered by the stone. An earthquake had exposed it all to daylight. 1,000 dwarven corpses lay, the victims of a darkspawn horde. Their last stand marked by one great ring of armor. In the middle, one small body. Clutching tightly to a small stuffed toy.
Tell me about a spirit you encountered.
The Alamari crossed the Frostback Mountains to escape a beast they called the Shadow Goddess in their story. I met the spirit that they fled. She walks the Fade along the southern tundra, weeping lonely and forgotten. Great Ferelden formed because a lonely spirit drove her prey away.
Tell me about the old memories you found in the Fade.
I saw a dwarf emerge into the light of day and shield his eyes against the sun. The first time he had seen it, the tears were streaming from his eyes. I thought them from the blazing light, until I saw the rock he held so tightly. Then he laid the rock down gently, and he left it as he walked away.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
They are dead, and the steps are done. It was, of course, simple. She has tracked her prey, knowing it meant gain or loss. For no other reason, she invited lives into death. The question, then, is whether or not she can stomach assassin as her path.
I am ready to become what I need to be, my assassin.
Then you are one of us. Hello, Inquisitor. My name is Air. It is nice to finally meet you. Come. You know the mind. Now let me show you the many ways to end a body.
Inquisition?
We need to head to Adamant Fortress as soon as possible. If there's a chance we can stop Corypheus from destroying the Wardens, we can't let it slip away.
What do you think we'll uncover in Adamant?
Nothing good. Hearing the Warden's plan was bad enough. Now we'll see it firsthand. Best case, we find a nightmare. Worst, we'll find a nightmare, then die painfully. I still can't believe what they're doing. I thought I understood the Order.
How much do you know about Corypheus?
Not much. I always thought the stories of magisters corrupting the Golden City were just that, stories. I didn't expect them to be true, and I certainly didn't expect to find one of them still alive.
Don't the Grey Wardens know everything about Darkspawn?
You don't have to know how a Darkspawn came to be in order to kill it. With soldiers, not historians. And the world would be better off if people focused on defeating evil rather than explaining how it came to be.
Corypheus stopped being human a long time ago. Darkspawn don't have human lifespans, do they?
No, I suppose they don't. They're unnatural and sustained by evil. It's been thousands of years. You'd think the Wardens would have managed to kill the first Darkspawn by now.
Do you know if there are more Darkspawn like Corypheus?
I don't know. I'm not sure any Warden knows.
Let's discuss something else. What do you think of the Inquisition?
I just know that you could shake this world to its foundations if you willed it.
We should return to our duties.
As you wish.
Has there been an exchange?
You're awful.
Not that. Gifts. Or perhaps betrothal.
Of a sort. Very romantic.
Ah, vicariously satisfied.
Inquisitor.
Pleasure.
Let's speak later.
Farewell.
We cannot neglect our soldiers' training.
Can we neglect roads? Our allies cannot take the same route through the mountains we did.
Really? You did not notice? I had no idea Lady Beverly was one of your people. You might have told me before I embarrassed myself. Let us begin. Let's see what we have.
moved in.
Welcome again, friend.
Dalen, I was wrong about your Inquisition. Although the humans named you herald of their prophet, your devotion to your people is undiminished. Perhaps you will be the bridge that others hope you are. If Lorinel still wishes to join you, he has my blessing. Dareth Sheral, Dalen.
I don't believe it. You convinced the Keeper. He said I can join the Inquisition if I wish.
Keeper Howen has given you permission to join the Inquisition.
He has. I'll report to your camp in the south, if that's all right.
Carry on, Agent.
Welcome again, friend.
Another completed work of whatever they used to call it.
A working nursery with not a space wasted will want for nothing.
Those who oppose thee shall know the wrath of heaven. What is a seeker of truth, exactly?
Sort of temper. You're rather insolent for a servant, aren't you?
You're a mage, not my patron. I've no reason to be polite to you.
Your patron is my patron, and he tasked you to accompany me.
To report should any Templars attack you, not cater to your every whim.
Do you know where this noble wanted to meet us?
I do. The Comte Boisvert invited us to his mansion, not far from here. I pray he clears up the deaths of my messengers, as promised.
Lead the way.
Welcome, my friend.
Thank you for seeing us, Comte Boisvert.
The honor is mine. Please, sit. It's an honor to assist two such distinguished guests.
I hope helping us doesn't endanger you.
Hardly. Even a brush with someone as well known as yourself can become a great asset in Val Royale. Giving you the identity of those who murdered Lady Montilly's messengers seemed the least I could do. Have you heard of the House of Repose?
The Assassins League?
My contacts obtained a copy of a document in the archives. Contract for life.
The House of Repose is hereby sworn to eliminate anyone attempting to overturn the Montilly's trading exile in Orlais.
They're not just after your messengers, Josephine. They'll try for you, too.
I am afraid so, yes.
The contract was signed by a noble family. The Du Parquets.
But the Du Parquets died out as a noble line over 60 years ago.
Indeed. But the contract was signed 109 years ago.
How can a family try to kill you after they died out?
The Du Parquets were our rivals. They drove the Montilliers from Val Royale. This contract was drawn up over 100 years ago, but it wasn't invoked until I tried to overturn my family's exile.
Unpleasant though it may be, the House of Repose is merely fulfilling its contractual duties.
If the people who wanted your family dead are gone, why are the assassins still after you?
A contract is a contract, Inquisitor. Orlesian businesses live and die by their reputations. The entire guild's welfare would be endangered if an agreement was tossed aside on a whim of time or fate.
She's quite right, Your Worship. The House of Repose is doing what it feels necessary, by its standards.
I assume you have a thought or two on this, Josephine?
The Du Parquets still have descendants under the common branch. If we elevate them to nobility, a Du Parquet could annul the contract on my life.
That will take time, Lady Montpellier. Time during which the House of Repose will be obliged to hunt you.
Will they now? You are exceedingly well informed, or not to have said you'd heard rumors at best.
A bit of subterfuge. This contract on your life is an ugly business, one the House of Repose deeply regrets. But this is Orlais. Even an assassin's word is his bond.
Does Comte Boisvert actually exist?
Absolutely. The Comte's offer to reveal the killers of Lady Montilly's messengers was genuine. So was his information, somehow. An end to be tied up later.
The House of Repose has some nerve sending a killer to greet us.
Hardly anyone in the League isn't trained for this, Inquisitor. The contract on Lady Montilly's life is so unusual, we felt the courtesy of an explanation was in order.
It is appreciated, Monsieur.
Your idea to seek out the Du Parquet to revoke our orders is an interesting one. I wish you luck. I did not come to shed blood today, Inquisitor. Only to speak. Might I pass?
Not on your life.
As you wish.
The last of them.
Well, that's the last time I agree to wait on the other side of a door when you're around. Are you two all right?
Yes, thank you, Lord Bavis. I think it's time we return to Skyhold. I've much to discuss with the Inquisitor there. Do you hear something?
Oh, goodness. Comte Poivre, is that you? Oh, the lock's been broken off. We'll find a saw. I realize the cabinet is quite valuable, Comte, but surely... A... locksmith, then? As you wish.
Worship.
I'm so sorry, Inquisitor. I never thought my family's trading status would trap us in an assassin's plot.
You couldn't have known it would lead to this House of Repose coming after you.
It still shouldn't have slipped past me. I've tracked down the last du Paraquets. If they become gentry, they can annul the contract on my life. We'll require a noble from Val Royaux to sponsor them, a judge to provide documents, a minister to ratify them.
It's so like you to take the longest course of action, even when your life is at stake.
I assume you already know everything about this mess.
There is a faster way, Josephine. The original contract on your life is in the vaults of the House of Repose. If my agents infiltrate it and destroy the original, the assassin will have no obligation to chase you.
Liliana, please. I want no more bloodshed over a personal affair.
Don't be so stubborn, Josie. How long will it take you to gather these favors in Val Royaux?
We can solve this without more deaths on either side.
My people are ready, should you change your mind. I'll post a watch on our ambassador in case the House of Repose visits.
I appreciate it, but I still believe elevating the du Paraquets will solve this. First, we need to perform some favors in Val Royaux. I'd be happy to discuss where we could begin.
Any news on the House of Repose, Inquisitor?
You said I'd have to do some favors in Val Royaux if we want to make the du Paraquets lords.
The Countess Dion is our first step. Her lover, a mage from the White Spire, is missing. Bring her news of him, and she'll be very amenable to sponsoring the du Paraquets as lords.
Thank you.
Darkspawn on the surface. I imagine Ferelden saw more than enough of them during the blight.
With the extra armor must lead the pack.
dispatch for you.